The ground cracked open in 6 seconds. In the heart of the Atacama Desert, one of the driest and quietest places on Earth, silence turned into chaos. Without warning, the Earth roared back to life and reminded Chile that nothing here is truly still. At exactly 1:15 p.m. on June 6, 2025, a 6.4 magnitude earthquake struck northern Chile near the town of Diego de Almagro. The tremor originated 76 kilometers below the surface, deep under the vast barren lands of Atacama. Although the magnitude was moderate compared to Chile's historical earthquakes, its timing, location, and impact captured national and global attention. In a matter of minutes, more than 23,000 people lost electricity. Alarms didn't sound, sirens didn't wail. There was no countdown, it just started. Buildings shook, walls cracked, windows shattered, roads buckled. People ran out of their homes, confused and terrified. The dust clouds that rose from the dry earth were so dense they turned the sky gray and filtered the afternoon sun into a strange apocalyptic hue.
Security camera footage from Diego de Almagro showed how suddenly things unraveled. A public bus veered to one side as the street beneath it moved like a wave. A local gas station had part of its concrete floor snap and drop several inches. In nearby schools, children screamed and ducked beneath desks. Supermarkets turned into chaos as shelves toppled and food scattered. Despite the intensity, no fatalities were reported. Authorities were quick to highlight Chile's strong building regulations and earthquake preparedness as key reasons why this event didn't turn into a tragedy. President Gabriel Boric addressed the country within hours, reassuring the public and promising rapid inspections and support for affected areas. He acknowledged the strength of national response systems, but reminded everyone that this was not an isolated event. It was a warning. Chile's location along the Pacific Ring of Fire puts it at constant risk for major seismic activity. The country sits directly above the boundary between the oceanic Nazca plate and the continental South American plate. This subduction zone is among the most active and dangerous in the world. Over centuries, pressure builds as the plates grind against each other. When that pressure is suddenly released, the result is often catastrophic. Although the June 6th quake did not cause mass destruction, experts warn that it may be part of a larger pattern. Some seismic agencies reported the magnitude closer to 6.6. Others indicated the epicenter may have been deeper or closer to certain fault segments that have remained quiet for too long. One of the most concerning details is that the Atacama region has not experienced a megathrust earthquake greater than magnitude 8 since 1922. That means over 100 years have passed without a full release of the tectonic energy that is known to accumulate in this segment of the fault.
Seismologists are not just looking at numbers, they are reading signals.
The Earth speaks in tremors and cracks. And what it said on June 6th was simple. I am still moving. Even more unsettling is the fact that this earthquake was not the only one. Just over a month earlier, on May 2nd, a 7.4 magnitude quake hit the Drake Passage south of Puerto Williams. It occurred far offshore, but was powerful enough to trigger tsunami alerts across southern Chile. Evacuations were ordered. People left their homes in the dark, holding flashlights and radios, waiting on higher ground. That earthquake did not cause structural damage or casualties, but it shook the country's sense of stability. Now, with two significant seismic events in less than 6 weeks, many are asking the same question. Is Chile entering a new phase of tectonic unrest? Emergency response teams have been working around the clock since the June 6th quake. Engineers are inspecting bridges, tunnels, hospitals, schools, and public infrastructure. Drone footage released by the National Emergency Office shows large cracks slicing across rural roads and hillsides. In one town, a hospital had to evacuate patients after a structural support beam was found to be weakened. In another, the main water pipeline ruptured, forcing hundreds of families to rely on emergency water deliveries. Despite the disruption, Chile's resilience stands out. Years of drills, reinforced construction standards, and rapid response systems are proving their worth. However, resilience does not eliminate risk. Preparedness cannot stop nature. It can only help reduce the damage. What would have happened if this earthquake struck at night while people were sleeping? What if it had been deeper or closer to a densely populated city like Antofagasta or La Serena? Would the results still be zero casualties? Would people have had enough time to respond?
These questions are not meant to cause panic. They are meant to spark preparation. Because earthquakes do not happen on schedules. They come without permission and without pause. One elderly resident of Diego de Almagro was seen walking through the ruins of his backyard, picking up shattered ceramic tiles and pieces of a photo frame. When asked by a journalist what he was looking for, he simply replied, "Proof that we were here before the ground forgot us." His words echoed with pain, but also with memory. This is a land that remembers. Geologists believe that the tectonic silence in northern Chile is deceptive. In their view, the longer a region remains quiet, the greater the force when it finally breaks. That is what makes Atacama's calm so haunting. No one knows exactly when the next major quake will strike, but few doubt that it is coming. Chile is one of the best prepared countries in the world when it comes to earthquakes. But even the best systems have limits. If a magnitude 8.5 or stronger quake strikes during peak hours or in the middle of the night, the scenario could change dramatically. The footage captured from June 6th offers more than just images of cracks and fallen shelves. It shows fear in the eyes of people who have lived through this before. It shows resilience in rescue workers and calm in the face of uncertainty. It shows the Earth reminding us that it still holds power over everything we build. This may not have been the big one, but it could be a preview. The fault lines are restless, the pressure is growing, the Earth is speaking, and we must listen. If your city faced the same earthquake tomorrow,
Chile's Hydrographic and Oceanographic Service estimated.
Mierda. Concha de madre. Ah, madre.